Hello Aquarians, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and this is the reading for you for the month of September, and they are all general readings which may or may not resonate with each and every one of you. So just and obviously one more thing is that they may be your energies of the person or the situation you are dealing with, or they may be the mix of both. So just please feel free to swap the characters according to your situation, and if the reading does not resonate with you, please check your moon sign as well as the Venus sign. Aquarians, there has been something with the Three of Swords which has really left you betrayed, or you are very upset about it and you feel shattered. It has really pierced your heart and it has obviously shattered you. You were in a painful situation, or you are still undergoing that phase. It will be different for different people, but this is only one card. All other cards are positive, so just be happy. With the Wheel of Fortune, things are turning in your favor. The things are moving. Okay, the fortune is giving you new opportunities, or if it is a relationship, maybe new relationship, whatever it is, it will be different for different people. But this thing is going with time, because you have the Eight of Wands. Now the Eight of Wands is all about communication. This can be actual communication through texts and messages, or it can be the communication or signals which the universe is giving you. It can be what suggestions what your friends are giving you. It can be anything. You have to be vigilant of the signs and the signals which the universe is giving you, because it is going to give you the Six of Cups. It is going to give you the happiness, and it is the Fool card, and it is followed by the Fool card, which is all about new energy. It is about a new beginning. You do not need any strategy. You do not have to plan anything. Universe will itself give you something, and you just have to take a leap of faith and follow it. That's all you are supposed to do, and it is going to give you happiness. So from this, because the Wheel of Fortune is in your card, the Wheel of Fortune is favoring you. You are getting the signals and the signs at the right time, so that you are able to move forward in the happy time. And the only thing is, everything is going to be fine if you just move with the destiny, move as the signals guide you, as the destiny guides you. You just have to totally surrender yourself to whatever life is offering you as for now, because whatever is happening for your good. And with the Four of Diamonds, there is some sort of hesitation to help others, or you are too preoccupied with material possessions. Maybe that is what you need to heal, or maybe you are hesitant because of this energy you have faced in your life with Three of Swords. Maybe that is why you are very hesitant. Just see, it is a closed door and this person is just peeping out. Okay, and only the eyes, just trying to seek some information, or too scared to come out, and entirely it is a door. This person is just peeping out from the door. Okay, so you are hesitant. I think you are hesitant rather than, or maybe preoccupied with the material possessions. Everything is behind the doors. You are not ready to come out or enjoy yourself, or come out of your own thoughts. Maybe if you are in an emotionally traumatic position, maybe you are not able to come out of the thoughts. It can be different for different people, but definitely there is hesitation. There is a sort of hesitation. It can be hesitation of to come out and value yourself and show up to people. It can be hesitation of mixing with people or living that life normally. You are too self-oriented or isolated. It can be, or maybe you are not helping others, maybe, or it is you are preoccupied with material possessions. Whatever it is, you are in an hesitant energy. But what I feel here is, it is because of this Three of Swords, and if you let go of this, things will solve. Just surrender to what life is offering you. Okay, with the Messenger of Thought, a new topic or intellectual project is really exciting for you. There is so much to learn before you feel free to ready to move forward. New information may require changes to your plans. Review all your documents carefully. Know how you know, and you will meet or are someone who loves to learn and share knowledge. This person is brilliant and truthful, and also blunt but not very diplomatic. So see, maybe hesitation to help others is because of this. Maybe you have a project and you want everything on your own. You don't want to share it. Maybe you don't want to share the credit, or you don't want to share some extra information you have. Whatever it is, it is exciting for you and you want it all, but maybe that is not right approach, and you need to involve others. You need to let go of this hesitancy. Maybe you are scared to share with them. Maybe it is not necessarily that you don't want to share. Maybe you are scared to share. You feel that they will spoil it. Whatever it is, it will be different. But yes, I think you have to come out of this negative energy and move forward. Okay, now this with Whispers of Love Oracle card number 4 may be of some significance for you. And you are limitless. You can do anything you choose. So now this is, I guess, what you really need to hear. It is just an insight card to give you inside as far as your personal life is concerned, be it yourself or with the people, loved ones around you, or attracting right kind of people if you are held up with negative people in your life. Okay, just see. It is a beautiful card. Just see, this is a unicorn rising up, and this female is totally surrendered to the universe. And this female, and there, just see the beautiful imagery, the peacock, the I should say the wings. This horn is all about the divine, the magic, and the swans. It's all about love. The only thing is, if you realize the power within you, the unicorn is just a uplifting energy, and it is totally divine ethereal energy which will lift you up from all the negativities in your life. But you should realize that you have that potential, you are limitless, and if you are in a negative phase of your life, you have to surrender to it. You have to understand your true potential. You have to realize that you can do what you want. What if something wrong has happened? Stop focusing on it. It just need to learn the lessons which were supposed to be taught by that event, and do not think that now you will not be able to create something new, or now you can't do anything about it. You can definitely rebuild your life. You can definitely move ahead. As far as your love part is concerned, even if you have failed relationships or mistrust, or you don't trust, or you have negative things, then you need to focus your attention towards self-healing, and you need to surrender yourself to the situation and understand. You have to first do the self-healing. You have to understand the clues which life is offering you, so that you are able to, I should say, do that inner work and heal yourself first, so that you are able to come to a position that you can take a correct decision about anything which is happening in your life. Okay, but you have to, basically you have to realize your inner potential. Okay, so thank you, and that's all I have for you. Please like and subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. Thank you.